Hello guys, welcome to Girlers Young Town. So today I'm here with the typical Kerala recipe. It's squid masala. So I'll tell you the recipe. Come on, follow me. To make the squid masala, I have my authentic clay pot here. To this, I'm going to add about 1/4 cup of coconut oil. Please add coconut oil. It will give nice aroma to it. I'm going to add, this is about 200 grams of shallots. I have crushed it. Now I'm going to fry them till it's nice and soft. To this I'm also going to add some curry leaves. This is about 8 green chilies. Now I'm going to make it really spicy. So I've got 8 green chilies crushed. And a very small piece of ginger, say about 1/2 inch of ginger, crushed. I'm going to stir fry this well. Now this is nice and brown. To this I'm going to add 1 tomato chopped. It should be really ripe. Add in 1 tomato chopped. Now close and cook them for another 10 minutes. So that the tomatoes also soften well. Now that our tomatoes have softened, I'm going to add our spice mixes. Here I have about 2 teaspoons of salt, 2 tablespoons of chili powder. Now we are only going to use chili powder, we are not going to use any other masala. We are going to use chili powder. If you want to make it more spicy, add according to your taste. Here since I've added about 8 green chilies, I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of chili powder and 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder. Cook till the masalas are really done. Keep checking in between so that it doesn't burn. To this I'm also going to add about 1 teaspoon of vinegar, white vinegar. If you have coconut vinegar, you can use coconut vinegar as well. Now here I'm going to use white vinegar to just to get the tangy flavor. Now our masalas have really cooked. I can see the oil coming out. So once this is done, I'm going to add our squid rings. I'm going to add our squids now. I've cleaned and cut them into bite-sized pieces. So I'm going to add them. Now squid take only 5 to 10 minutes to cook. So do not add water. It has water in itself, so you don't need water. It's going to be a dry masala, like with very little gravy. So I'm going to cover and cook it for another 10 minutes. In 5 to 8 minutes it will be done, but I'm going to give it extra 2 minutes so that it is really done. Now that our water has dried up well and it has become a nice thick gravy, now it's ready to serve. Do not overcook the squid for long. My squid has been cooking for 8 minutes exactly. So do not overcook it because then it will turn rubbery. Now it's nice and buttery. Now I'm going to transfer this to a bowl and serve it with hot ghee rice. Wow, finally my squid masala is ready. I'm going to taste it with some ghee rice. It's buttery soft. The masalas have really done well. Guys, do try this at home. Do let me know what you guys think. So before we sign out, do like, share and subscribe. Thank you for all the support. See you with the next recipe soon. Bye bye.